I planted that tree when it was a coconut about 10 years ago. About 20 minutes after leaving the airport on the bus for Varadero, you'll go by this big new hotel, a foreign Cuban partnership. And right next to the hotel is a canal and exiting out into the ocean. That canal divides Hikkako's Peninsula to the north from mainland Cuba. Another couple of kilometers past that to the east is Club Kawama. You'll see it from the bus as you drive along the south side of this canal. When you come from the airport, don't change your money at the airport or on the bus. You don't need many Cuban pesos. Most of the staff, most of Cuba wants your foreign currency and would like you to pay in foreign currency and will give you a much better exchange rate than you'll get from any official. You'll come to a bridge about 9th Street in Varadero, connecting the town of Santa Marta on the mainland to the town of Varadero on Hikkako's Peninsula. Varadero town stretches from where we are, where Kawama starts, is about 5th Street. You can pick up the all-day hop-on, hop-off tourist bus for $5 for the day at 7th Street, and the town runs east to about 64th Street. Past that is the newer hotels, the golf course, and a bunch more newer hotels going out to the end of the peninsula, which has been gradually covered over recent decades. Kawama is a three-star Cuban-owned resort that I've been coming to with my wife since 2007, every January until COVID stopped us last year. It's the best value for low price you can find in a winter vacation from Canada out of Toronto and get a week for $700 or less. So there's no complaining about it not being a five-star when you're paying that sort of price. It's at 91 years old, the oldest in Varadero, but it has the most repeaters of any resort in Cuba. So come on down and join the family.
Okay, I might have gotten a little carried away tonight with the chicken and the ham. I deserve it. I'm on vacation. I'm above the main buffet of Club Kawama, not far from the main pool, and I'm going into room number 804. I'll enter. I'll start out here and show you the mirrored closet. Here we have a large sink area and mirror. Oh, tile floor with a step. Beautiful washroom. There's the toilet. Tiled wall. And shower in the tub. Back out through the hall, we'll go back and have a look at this bedroom. And it's a large bedroom. Got a couple of tables, a couple of lamps. There on the floor is your refrigerator and freezer. Television. Air conditioner's running. It's nice and cool in here. couple of big glass panes overlooking the north side of the buffet, the beach, and kind of a large patio here. So this is very private and beautiful. At a three-star, you learn little tricks like I saved some ham at dinner yesterday in a Ziploc bag and had them put it on next to my eggs on the grill this morning to make breakfast of ham and eggs to go with my view. I came into El Risolino at lunch and Ana Isa has made me this hamburger and my beer's on the way. Exiting the hotel lobby are some chairs where people get drinks from the lobby bar next to the little kiddies pool. Building 16 in front of us, a washroom, shower, the main pool, entertainment area, the pool bar where you get beer, a couple or three little craft gift shops, and another pool shower. We're located next to building number 2. There goes Anna Margarita down the stairs. Completing the turn here, we have building number 1 right next to the main lobby. I'm having my first lunch at Club Kawama in 2022, January 23rd. I made a salad, got a piece of chicken, threw a couple of things on like some Asian salad topping and Asian sesame salad dressing, even a little of that 7-year-old cheddar, those things I brought with me, and a cold draft beer. And in a fairly full buffet at Kawama. I asked for a rare steak, and I don't know if you can see it, but it is. Then I saved a little butter and smeared some of that on my potato and steak. I think I'm going to enjoy it. There's a chicken dinner over here, and it looks pretty good too. I've come up to room 402 to show the shower, tub, toilet. Here's a double closet, sink, mirror, couple of beds. Maid's just been here making them. I kicked her out. Well, I did this air conditioner on the wall. We have a refrigerator, television on the wall, and just out here we have a oceanfront location and a large covered patio. Lots of room to enjoy views of the ocean, only steps away. And we're right next to the buffet as well, and not far from the main pool. I have eaten most of the flaky fish and the potato, And then I realized I didn't show you this delicious flaky fish that I'm having on the end of my first day at Club Kawama, El Risolino a la carte.
The beach in Varadero on Hikako's Peninsula stretches for 20 kilometers of the most beautiful sand you'll see anytime, anywhere. Kawama is at least a kilometer long stretch of it along the west end of the peninsula. This is all Kawama here. Lots of beach chairs and umbrellas. Right in front of us now is the buffet. And right next to that is the a la carte El Risolino. You can get pizza, hamburgers at lunch. Below that is the beach bar. And my friend Odell. I've been a good boy this trip though, haven't been giving him much business. There's building 876. Different numbering system. The one you're looking at there in the distance is building 45. And back to the beginning of this circle. I've come inside the buffet just after they've opened for lunch. I'm on the sunny southern side. On this wall, there's a few plates of meats. Next to the breakfast grill where the eggs are done in the morning. Right now, they've got it loaded up with chicken. Lots of chicken. Back to the north, they're lined up for ice cream. And to my left, they have rice. Looks like a beef stew, some banana, a couple of kinds of soup. Head back this way, you've got a more, looks like a chicken on a grill. Right behind us is salad table. They have individual servings. My voice is muffled because we're all wearing masks. And you just take the whole plate and put on your plate these little plates of whatever you choose to take. You see some green tomato, carrots, kale. There's a little lettuce there. My wife actually prefers this new presentation because she feels it's even cleaner. You see some plates of fruit that has been disappearing quickly. There's some pears there. They're good, I've had them. Some peaches. Guava, I think. Pineapple looks a little hard to me. These are odd presentations to me, or an odd combination. I generally will grab a fork from my table and then come along and just take out what I want from those big bowls so that I'm not polluting someone else's food. Here they have a steam tray with spaghetti, some cooked ham and pineapple, cabbage, mashed potatoes, squash, and rice and beans, some plates. This is the North Ocean side of the buffet. And just behind me here is the bread table with the toaster. It rolls through there and toasts up the bread. It's a busy place in the morning. And there's Dinah.
Hi, Michael. How are you?
I am upstairs in the newly renovated building number 8, room number 802, next to the buffet and El Wrestlino restaurant. Going inside, you'll see a smaller bed. It has its own refrigerator, television, air conditioner. There's a window overlooking the ocean there and there, closed at the moment. Coming into a little entrance room. And here we will go into a large bedroom, couple of beds, air conditioner on the wall, refrigerator in the corner, television on the wall, closet, safe, out to this newly renovated washroom. And it's got some new plumbing. Looks like somebody's washed some beach sand off of their feet in it. But that is this newly renovated building number 8. As you can see, we've got views of the ocean all around. And again, leaving building number 8, this is their patio. Covered, magnificent view. Nighttime at the Kawama lobby bar. Surrounded by tourists speaking multiple languages. The beautiful setting. Lady in the yellow, it's her 50th anniversary today. Her husband's in the red. I know you're all getting tired of looking at my meals, but I have to show you one more from this Cuban-owned resort. This could be the start of a very long night at Club Kawama. Another 3-star breakfast. That's a joke. Welcome to the rest. What you mean? Welcome to the land.
I have just come into room 2317. That's room 17 in building 23. You can see the sink, mirror, going into a bathroom, shower, clean as a whistle, toilet. Here we have the mirrored sink area, and also behind me here is a closet with a safe on the wall. Coming into the room, you'll see a TV. Above, a refrigerator. There's a little freezer compartment in there. Air conditioner is running. It's nice and cool in here. And this room has a view from here over the canal. We're down close to the southeast corner of the resort. See, there's a couple of lamps, some beds. And that is what you're going to get in a regular room at Club Kawama.
I asked for pork chops, but I didn't quite expect that big a meal. Going with another salad at lunchtime at the La Tosca buffet, and they had some ham, so I had them slice some of that up, and cold beer and a pretty prime table.
That's building 26 in front of us. Just a few feet over those bushes is the ocean, the beach and the ocean, right next to the smaller pool of the Club Kawama property, not being used a great deal at the moment. There's building 17 in front of us. The main pool, you can see the blue of right there. We're next to the coffee bar right here. There's building 11 and 12. Again, back to the beach. There's a walkway to the beach.
The lunch at the buffet is very tasty. Ham that I've got there on the right. I've made a salad, and along with my beer. You can see I've brought some things from home, and a few things that you like can make quite a difference in your enjoyment of meal. So whatever you like, you might consider bringing some.
Tienda Carey in the southeast corner of Club Kawama doesn't have much stock in there during days of COVID, but it's right across the street, I believe 5th Street from Tortuga Resort, and on the edge of the canal separating the peninsula from the mainland, and next to what upstairs was Grand Canal Restaurant. Down below there's a renovated place that's selling beer, and you can sit on that patio there and watch the beautiful old cars drive by. This is a map of the Kawama grounds just outside of the reception lobby. And right now, because it's slow, they're only open from building 45 to the left on this picture, but you can freeze that and figure out the ground layout. We're having chicken vegetables at El Rosalino restaurant, the a la carte at Club Kawama. Glass of white wine. And some good company. On entering the main lobby, you come pretty quickly to reception, where you check into the hotel. And a lot of people like to sit here. The desk in front of us on the wall is where you get your reservations, starting at 10 most days of the week. In front of us here is the lobby bar. And Yvonne and Janya.
Jenny is the head of entertainment at Kawama. Vamos a recibir con un fortísimo aplauso, clap your hands, para la compañía de baile.
Si me agota la paciencia, cualquier pecado. Cada beso yo te levanto al rayar el día. Mi delirio perdura siempre al llegar la noche. Paso a alto, llegue la aurora y la de goce. Segunda que con la sola tu alma y la pena.
There's Santa Marta and the bridge crossing onto Hakako's Peninsula. The narrow stretch there holds Kawama.